we built the Christie lift, and five of us ran it the first year. As you all know, it opened on January 12, 1963, 40 degrees below zero, and that day we had one customer.
Friends that I've made in the bright mountain days aren't forgotten or lost, though I've wandered away. They will be there in the forest and grove, speaking out from the past that my memory woke.
There's a limited terrain here for Nordic skiing. Whether you want to ski at the touring center, you know, where we have about 25 kilometers of prepared tracks in anywhere from novice level skiing to more advanced. In fact, we could say that Steamboat would definitely be the only place in Colorado where we could hold all skiing events included in the Olympic Games.
Call to me, river that runs through the canyon. Sing to me, birds of the high mountain side. Tell me it's there in the mountains, it's waiting. Peace for all brothers, the world's sweet surprise.
I think Steamboat Springs is called Ski Town USA probably because the whole town is based around skiing. I mean, you've got winter carnivals that have been going on for almost 80 years, and there's a ski touring center, and there's Howson Hill where all the kids can go down after school and ski, and then you've got Mount Warner, and I think there's more Olympians that have come out of Steamboat Springs, this little town of 6,000, than anywhere else in the country.
Tell me it's there in the mountains, it's waiting. Peace for all brothers.
Steamboat is really a ski town. It's a ranching town, a cowboy town. It's got one of the best ski areas right on the edge of it. It's a really sophisticated ski area, very much like Aspen or Vail. It'll compare with any ski area in the country, both in size and sophistication and what it offers in restaurants and ski trails and après-ski activities. But it's also part of Steamboat Springs, ranching town, 100-year-old ranching town, where the people are really friendly. The two comments that I get from people when they come to Steamboat, or when I see them when I'm traveling around the country, are about the friendliness of the people and the size of the mountain. They're surprised to see one of the biggest ski mountains in the country here, but they're just amazed at how friendly all the people are.
America, you are gonna love it.
Come with me. I want to show you how easy it is to get up this mountain. This is the Silver Bullet, Steamboat's new high-speed, 8-passenger gondola. Hang on. Here we go. This wonderful new lift can carry up to 2,800 skiers every hour to the top of Thunderhead. Now, to give you a little perspective, that's 70 busloads of people every hour going up this lift.
Steamboat Silver Bullet takes only 9 minutes to get to the top of Thunderhead, and a car leaves every 10 seconds. But the Silver Bullet is just one of 20 lifts spread out over the entire mountain. And computerized lift status signs are stationed around the mountain to tell skiers where the shortest lines are. Not that waiting is a problem. Even during peak season, most days you won't find any lines. Yes, at Steamboat, you can get up the mountain about as fast as you can get down.
It's almost 1 o'clock, and I've got a date with some skiers. I'll see you on the slopes. So anyway, does anybody want to go skiing in this group?
Yeah.
All right, I'll tell you what I do. This is basically a free clinic that I do, and we'll head down an intermediate trail called Heavenly Days right underneath the gondola, and we'll stop every few hundred yards along the way, and I'll tell you some things that might help your skiing out. When you ski on the ice, maybe when you get back home, because we don't have any ice here, that you'll be able to ski better on the ice. Okay, so stand on your skis like a racer. It's a lot easier. Feet apart, but you'll ski better if you keep your hands out and use them for balance. All right, so here we go.
There are lots of ski areas around the country. Steamboat is one of the best, one of the biggest. But the town here really has had skiing as part of its history and development for a long time.
You know, the ski area in Steamboat's been running since 1963, but we've been skiing here in Steamboat since 1913. This equipment back here represents skiing even back into the 1880s, when you just basically had a board that was turned up in the pointed end with a strap across your toe. Now, the equipment has changed so much, and as you look at some of this equipment now, you can see the evolution of it from just plain wooden planks with a hole, with a strap going over the toe, and now you see more sophisticated bindings and boots and so forth, right up to the modern day where you just stand and move your knees and the skis turn automatically.
From the air, big and beautiful. You see the mountain in all its glory from the air. And you get a gander at many of its 100 runs in one of the Rockies' biggest lift systems. And through the air, Steamboat is the easiest Colorado mountain to get to. The simple reason, you fly nonstop on American Airlines to Steamboat from Dallas, New York, Chicago, in San Jose. And you fly nonstop on Northwest Airlines from Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Los Angeles. And American West flies from Phoenix 3 days a week. Our new Yampa Valley Regional Airport is just 22 miles from skiing, the kind of beautiful skiing you see here. Continental also flies nonstop to the Yampa Valley Regional Airport from Houston and Cleveland. And we're served by Continental Express from Denver, which flies right into the Steamboat Springs Airport, just 5 miles from the slopes. Continental Express offers as many as 8 daily flights to Steamboat on their 48-passenger airplanes. Steamboat also has connections from 150 cities worldwide. So when it comes to flying, there's no easier Colorado mountain to get to. And when you get here, there's one part of Steamboat you've just got to see.
Play
when the lovers find each other and know just the word to say. Night, night, when you go to the active, bright and attractive sight. You find the taste appeal of that after eight grade meal. The sweet guitar really hits your heart and lets you know how good you feel. The nights when Steamboat Springs alive. The nights you feel it in your feet. It's the time for sweet romancing or just dancing down the street. Night, night, time for the party under the starry light. Gonna take the night in stride, this boat on the starry side. Come along, 'cause you can't go wrong on this nighttime ride.
Play at night. When you ski Steamboat, you discover right away that it's one of the best groomed mountains in America.
The Steamboat Ski School has a large staff of qualified ski instructors who teach ages 3 to adults as old as you want to be. In the 15 years that I've been here working with the Steamboat Ski School, we found that the most important thing is to let our guests have a good time. We want to be your friend.
Let's go. Come on out.
Friend. Yes, a friend I am. I'll go up with you or down with you and stick with you to the very end, 'cause I'm your friend. I'm your pal, and it's more than just occasional. In the snowy bank, if you take a fall, guess who's there to heed your call? Yes, I'm your friend. Old Robinson Crusoe, he had his friend Friday to help him get by days that were dreary and bleak. And whenever you're down, chum, you'll know I'm around, chum, because a Friday friend I'm not. You got me all week. I'm your friend. No matter what comes around the bend, if you lose control and down you go, while going down, it's nice to know that I'm your friend. Learning the ropes, taking a fall, sometimes it's a try. When it's cold and what you need's a warm and friendly smile, well, we're your friend.
It's been going on now for over 75 years. The Steamboat Winter Carnival. The wild, fun, traditional week that could only happen in Ski Town, USA.
Thank you. Cutter races started because the ranchers and that around here didn't have anything to really do in the wintertime, so they build a sled and put runners on it, and then they get out in the wintertime with their saddle horses and everything and hook them up as a team and run races, one rancher against another, and it makes a lot of fun for everybody.
Overlooking the town of Steamboat Springs is one of America's finest ski jumping complexes, and often the home of our national ski jumping championships. Steamboat Springs is also the home of the annual Cowboy Downhill, and in the middle of every January, the mountain is invaded by cowboys when the professional rodeo riders come into town.
Like them to be upright when they go through the finish line, and that's a pretty heavy task for a lot of these guys. They come out and learn how to ski in the morning, and then they spend a couple hours in the bar training at lunch. Then they come out here and race. It ought to be a good one.
An up and down place. You go up, you come down, delightfully. But not always on skis. There are other kinds of ups and downs to do here. Take a ride on a big balloon, the colorful way to fly. Become a part of one beautiful picture in the sky. Or come down on a ride on a waterfall. A nice way to end your days. Yep, Steamboat's a town with its ups and downs. In so many fabulous ways.
Art Linkletter, a family man enjoying my annual vacation in a family resort. That's right, Steamboat Springs is a Colorado vacation spot where Western values based on kids and families has become the trademark for this historic valley behind me. What a place, and what a history.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Hartford.
Old man, but I never got the hang of a ranch bar. I was growing up a deckin' in the Illinois trade with coal dust in my hair. I got stuck in the ice on Christmas Eve and I froze myself, it's true. See, it's a shivering and a shaking with the down south case of them steamboats are so blue. Oh, Captain, well, I'm sorry, my hat is off to you. You've been hanging out by the old cook stove with the steamboats are so blue.
The Ute Indians started coming into this part of the country when they got themselves horses from the Spaniards. But they had enough sense to leave each fall before the winter snows came. Then white settlers started arriving in the 1870s, built themselves cabins, brought in cows, chickens, maybe a pig or two, so they weren't so mobile. When winter came, many of them just had to stay and stick it out. For 6 long months of each year, maybe more, the snow cozied up around the cabins, deep and unending. If you wanted to go anywhere, you had to plow through it or try to walk over it. That's why skis were a fact of life in Steamboat Springs right from the beginning.
Snow in the wintertime, seemed to me, came about halfway up on the windows.
When I was in grade school, which would be in the 20s, there were no cars running during the wintertime. People would generally put them in a garage and put them up on blocks so that the weight wouldn't be on the tires. And so wherever we went, we skied or walked, or if we could hitch a ride on the back of a sled, that was great. And lots of sleds and lots of teams pulling the sleds, of course. And it was a nice, easy way of living, and yet it was pretty hard too, because we'd get lots of snow.
I skied to town, to school. It was 2 miles, and it was uphill going in, but I could, when I hit the top of the hill, I could go downhill, you know, for quite a ways.
Skiing just was it, with a capital I, in Steamboat Springs, because there wasn't much other activity.
Equipment was catch-as-catch-can. It could be barrel staves, store-bought or homemade.
Bill Law made our skis, and he made a pair for me. They were made out of pine, and they were light, and they just had a strap across the top.
The first pair I had was made by Art Gumphrey, handmade, which didn't even resemble our present ski at all. I believe the first skis that any of us ever used were barrel stays.
We used a Northland binding, which was held on with two bolts, and then a piece of latigo leather with a loop tied in one end, then folded and shoved through the ski, went back and forth around your heel and over your instep, and there you were for the day. You didn't take the skis off like you do today. When you put them on, they were on there to stay. We'd go over to Witherhill and ski till dark and time to do your chores. And when I get through skiing, my gloves would just be hanging on the ends of my fingers. And I'd ski right in the kitchen and wait for those bindings to thaw. And then when they thawed out, then I'd go take my skis off and do my chores.
And like all the kids in Steamboat, I grew up on skis. My mother used to put me out the back door long, long before I ever went to school on my skis. And if I'd fall off of them, because there was only a little toe strap, I'd be stuck in the snow, and she'd have to come out and dig me out.
Well, whatever the problems, you had to admit, skis kept the kids out of the house in the winter. And skiing for pleasure was kid stuff and would remain that way until 1913, when Carl Howelson, known as the Flying Norseman, arrived on the train and decided to stay. 36 years old, he'd been a champion ski jumper in Norway, and more recently, a performer with the Barnum and Bailey Circus, jumping on skis from a scaffold to clear the backs of two elephants.
7 years after we'd been in Steamboat, we moved to Strawberry Park, and our house was right next door to Carl's, to Carl Howelson. He was a skier. We knew he was a skier. I and my sisters had skied for several years, so we thought Carl Howelson was very entertaining. He was a little short-legged fellow. His legs were a little bit bowed, just exactly right to ski.
Steamboaters agreed he was an exotic, all right. They'd never seen ski jumping. They'd never seen skiing with two poles and had never used the odd new lighter skis. Howelson, with his up-to-date ways, would be opening doors. He would be getting people moving. Life in Steamboat would never again be the same. In the winter of 1914, Howelson put on Steamboat's first winter carnival, building a jumping scaffold on Woodchuck Hill and arranging for ski jumpers to come in from the outside to compete. Everyone in town big enough for boots and mittens was there. Ranch families from miles around hitched up sleds and were on hand. And although there were various other ski races and competitions, the biggest draw was the jumping feature. A dozen local boys entered the amateur meet, and four imported professionals competed against the Flying Norseman, who won handily with a leap of 108 feet. After that, every child wanted to be a ski jumper. Little jumps were piled together on hills all over town and far out in the countryside.
One up on Crawford Hill, called Weber Hill, up where the old golf course used to be. And there was one on Woodchuck. There was one on Wither Hill. There was one up there in Smith's Pasture. And then there was the Sulphur Cave, and the kids from Fairview came over and jumped on that, mostly. And then as the winter progressed, we'd probably get over to Howelson Hill and jump on the jumps over there.
We used to love to jump on their jumps, and they'd get them all. They'd work for days. The boys would have tournaments and have pocket knives or a special pair of agates and different treasures that they would give us prizes for the longest jump. And of course, all the gals would come along and they'd ruin their jumps, but they did put up with it.
We jumped on the man killer.
Oh yes, we did jump on the man killer. The man killer was on Withers Hill. It was up straight up the mountain, and it was a donkey jump. It's a jump that is built up so that it takes you up in the air just as high as you can get, and heaven only knows where you land or how you land. But we would go clear to the top of Withers Hill and head them down, straight down, and go off the donkey jump. And we had to get across the street, naturally. And then you landed in a flat place. How we kept from breaking our necks, I don't know.
All this commotion was bound to make an impression. In 1915, a group of townspeople sat down together and organized a ski club, the Steamboat Springs Winter Sports Club, and joined the National Ski Association, making their outfit the first official ski club west of the Mississippi. Now, the idea was to make sure the distance records set on Howelson's hills could be registered as official. And also in the plans were jumping contests for the youngsters. Carl Howelson was never a man to stand still. That same year, he crossed the Yampa River and built a jumping scaffold on a north-facing slope in what was then called the Elk Pasture, a move destined to change the lifestyles of both the town's captive elk herd and its citizens. Steamboat's second winter carnival, like the first, centered on jumping. The event was more exciting than ever, and the new jump was destined to stay. All that winter, Steamboat's young jumpers hurried after school to cross the river and the railroad track to go through the gate and jump on Carl Howelson's new hill.
When we were in school, we'd jump as late as we could in the afternoon, and then we'd have to go home, but we'd leave our ski poles out in the flat, and we'd try to catch them on the fly as we went by so we could go clear over to the tracks before we'd have to slow down.
Well, it's quite a thrill, and I would recommend if you're going to jump that you start as a kid and work up. I've talked to fellows that rode wild horses and steers, and they said they wouldn't get on a pair of skis for love nor money, and I wouldn't get on the steer.
Well, there was some truth to that, so street events were added to Winter Carnival. Lots of horse events, ski-joring down Main Street. Every sort of ski-joring, hurdles, ring, and spear, diamond hitch formations, and flat-out races.
Oh, that was the biggest thing. I mean, you know, the ski-joring and the, you know, the events downtown, yeah. I mean, street events, geez, you knew the ranchers, you knew the horses, you knew what horse you wanted to ride behind, you know. In there, who was riding the horse? I mean, it was a big thing. That
I brought in a horse one year to the ski carnival in 1938. In fact, I came in the first day and I took third place in the men's cross country race. Next day, I brought a horse in and I won the ladies' ski joring race. And they gave the prizes at the Chief Theater on a Sunday night. And I got to go up twice. I won a third prize, a flashlight, in the men's cross-country ski race. And I won a pound of cheese for the horsemen in the ladies' ski joring race.
I won a pair of socks one year.
See what they do in that town. They have the darndest ski races you ever saw, right down the middle of the main street. The whole country turns out to watch. And it's hard to believe that people would do things like that just for fun. But the people of Steamboat Springs are rugged, believe me. I was only a spectator, but I was scared to death. Anyone who thinks the younger generation is getting soft should take a trip to Colorado. The winner was a mild-mannered lad, and to look at him, you'd never guess he'd indulge in anything more hair-raising than checkers. They set up little hurdles in the street, just the thing to catch a ski under. They're so ski-minded, I expect the horses to be jumping over those things on skis by next year. In fact, as far as I could see, the horses had the best of it, unless some overeager skier should run them down from behind. But the horses are good-natured, as are the fathers and the uncles and the brothers and cousins recruited to tow these young daredevils. It didn't look much like Highway 40, but that's where they hold their ski races, in Steamboat Springs. Yep, right down the middle of Highway 40, and the traffic has to detour around. But you don't have to own a horse to get into the show. Every little kid in town was out there giving his all for good old Steamboat Springs. And believe me, the winner of this race is a town hero.
The Steamboat just went around carnivals. Our winters were completely around carnivals. There was no business in town. People from ranches would come in and buy a little bit of groceries and all, but there was nothing to do.
Up until the early 30s, it was all pretty much skiing in a straight line. Touring about the countryside, jumping, ski-joring, everybody did just fine as long as no fancy turns were required. In those days, downhill skiing demanded great courage and foolish optimism. The single stout pole that had once acted as both a rudder and a brake had been discarded. and the newer pair of lighter poles were no help at all. So it was just push off, straight down, ride as long as possible, and then bail out in a bone-knocking crash. So after a while, everybody in town you saw had a wet, snowy look.
Oh gosh, I'll never forget a blue pair of ski pants I had, and they were wool. That heavy wool stuff. And you'd fall down, and if the snow was just right, you'd get great big snowballs all over your pants.
Oh, yeah.
Remember?
Yeah. Certainly do.
Just like dog stomachs.
Carl Howelson had returned to Norway by then, but there were to be other profits. In January of 1931, a gentleman hired by the railroad to promote skiing arrived in Steamboat, prepared to demonstrate the newest downhill and slalom and the radical Christiana turn that made them possible. Well, Steamboaters took to the new technique right off. Spent the rest of the winter trying to work out just how that darn thing went. In 1935, Steamboat's Winter Sports Club hired a Denverite to come over the mountains and give a month's instruction to its members. After that, nothing would ever be the same again. All that remained between steamboat skiers and a lovely freedom was a few trees. Right next to the jump on Howelson Hill.
We decided that alongside there was a good enough slope there that we could make some trails. And so we started cutting a few trees out. And then one day, Buddy Werner's father, Ed, said, let's go up there and cut all those cotton-picking trees out.
The newly cleared hill by the jump soon came alive. The young grasshoppers came over, forgetting the jumps for a while, and became first-rate four-way skiers. The process took a while, but it was going to produce some real surprises.
He was going down just slow, doing 90 miles an hour when he caught the edge of his skis. Well, his clothes, they were fast, but the slopes, they were faster. That pole, that's a super skier we shall see.
He was slipping down that slope, doing 90 miles an hour, when a mogul flipped him into the air. Now his jumping form was fine, till he led into a pine, and two one-legged skis.
Before long, the high school band director was announcing that since his students skied better than they played, he'd put them on skis for the Winter Carnival Parade. His musicians, possibly the world's only skiing band, would become a cause for pride and a lasting tradition.
We had lots of fun skiing. It didn't bother us skiing, trying to keep in step skiing. What bothered us was on a cold day, the instruments froze. You would try to blow a pleasant note on a trumpet and forget it.
We would ski down the street and there'd be icicles maybe 3 or 4 inches long coming out of some of the instruments.
Progress continued. A tow was contrived to haul skiers up the Howelson Slope. It was called the boat tow. Wasn't much to look at, but it certainly was an interesting ride.
And after you rode the boat tow, you decided it was really better to climb the mountain. That was the roughest ski lift in existence. And it went from not just rut to rut, it went from gulch to gully. And you weren't in the greatest shape for skiing after too many rides on that boat tow.
By now, skiing was the heart, the very center of wintertime Steamboat. And during the next three decades, Little Howelson Hill, with a vertical rise of only 400 feet, would produce more world-class skiers than any other hill in any other town in the United States. It's hard to say when the real four-way competitive edge began. Easiest point to mark probably is 1943, when the Winter Sports Club hired Al Wegeman, a ski instructor from Winter Park, to start teaching classes for youngsters. His program flourished and within 4 years was included in the school curriculum with the blessing of the school board. His classes held on Howelson Hill usually lasted until after dark, continuing under lights until dinner time. In January of 1949, one of Steamboat's first Olympians, Gordon Wren, returned to take over the junior ski program from Wegeman, who was off to Sun Valley. Gordon Wren was a veteran of the Mankiller, Wither Hill, and all the other little jumps that children had once built. He spoke the language. He knew the kids. Feisty, uncompromising, he made a good coach.
When the man came along called Gordy Wren, that I think Bugs would have to agree changed all of our lives. he was a great coach, very inspirational person, not only in our skiing, but also in our grades in school, our living habits. I mean, he was a real taskmaster that we all behaved very well. I mean, he just wouldn't put up with anything but the best. And I really have to credit him for bringing everything that I think that Buddy and Loris and I did.
You know, I don't know how I really become a competitive skier other than really through Gordy. Gordy just made it fun for us.
This was the spirit that would produce 19 U.S. ski team members and alternates, 20-some FIS World Championship team members, 5 members of the U.S. Ski Hall of Fame, 14 in the Colorado Ski Hall of Fame, and 3 members of the Colorado Sports Hall of Fame. Almost all of these came along at a time when the total population of Steamboat was about 3,000.
Now here is Buddy Werner of the United States. Buddy in ninth place going into the second run. The try of a lifetime for Bud Werner, his last chance in the Olympics at the age of 27. He's only a second and a half out of third place in a bronze medal right now. Here he goes. All the years that have gone before mean nothing now except in the way they have prepared Buddy Werner for this moment, for these 60 seconds. He needs a time of 61.26 to take the lead at the moment.
That's a start. Fast start out of that course up here now, Jim, in the upper part of this thing. Doing very well. Oh, a little bit off on his edges there. Quick recovery.
Once again, when the pole falls down, that does not necessarily mean he missed a gate. You skiing enthusiasts may find that repetitive, but a lot of people don't know that, I think.
He's pushing all the way, Jim. A little bit back there, a little back.
Did he miss the gate? Definitely?
I don't know for sure that he has. We'll have to wait for the jury. He's back on his feet, definitely off balance. Now he's going to fight through this last pitch here into the finish, which is very steep.
Buddy Werner fighting it all the way on the last chance he's got.
Buddy Werner, we're quite aware that this is a steep course, but how does course number two here compare to the first one?
Oh, it's not as hard as the first one, Jim. It's about 20 gates short at the first one, and it's just an all-around easier course, I think.
How about the ice? We note that the ice is up there. Is that a little dangerous as you go on this final
pitch
off?
Yes, you have to be very careful in that, Jim, but it's not. I don't think it's quite as steep and quite as hard as the first one. Perhaps it's warmed up a little bit to make it a little more grippy.
What do you do, catch a tip or something?
No, I didn't catch a tip. I just caught one of the edges there, and it threw me outside in the course, and then I had to kind of spin around and come back in again.
Buddy, thank you so much for talking with us.
Sure. The Flying Norseman's jumping hill has come along well, too. Over the past few decades, Howelson Hill has seen the setting of 10 national 90-meter distance records, the first recorded when Howelson's good friend Ragnar Omvet flew 192 feet during the 1916 Winter Carnival. The latest, established by Jim Denny in 1978, was marked at 354 feet. Not bad on a jump with a vertical rise of just 440 feet. Today's Howelson Jumping Complex is one of the three largest in the country, hosting many of the world's best jumpers, serving as home for a training program that is producing top competitors for tomorrow. The story doesn't end there. Steamboat's pioneer push has transferred to the high, forested rise of the Continental Divide, east of town, and continues strong as ever. From the beginning, 10,600-foot Storm Mountain, with its shining snowfields and long ridges, had beckoned to the skiers. For the skiers down in the valley, it was the big one, the finest challenge. For each turning point in history, there's a man. The man who came forth to change things in 1955 was Jim Temple, a 28-year-old Sun Valley ski patrolman, avalanche expert, and son of Rock County ranchers. Temple had looked up to that mountain as others had, but with a difference.
Early on, I decided, I think in the early 50s, that I was going to investigate that mountain and see how feasible it really was. It was on all the main lines for automobile and train access and airline. Together with the great snow that Steamboat gets and the early snows on Storm Mountain, deep snow. It just looked like it had to be a natural. The first lift was a pommel lift, 2,200 feet long, and went up Cub Claw, which was at the base of Bear Claw, which I guess now is called Christie. Ski in the sunshine, smooth, open slopes. It's Colorado's newest and smoothest. And the lift tickets, low rates, adults $2 a day, under 12, a dollar a day. We had a warming house, a snack bar, and ski lessons.
Others would join in the project, among them John Fetcher, a Philadelphia engineer turned rancher, and Buddy Werner, an Olympian and one of Steamboat's favorite sons. Those who live in the high country will tell you, no one can own a mountain. Storm Mountain rose above the dream, asking to be served, demanding a larger scale, requiring more money than local sources could provide.
I think it was 1962. That a new group came in to take over for the mountain, and we started getting money together to build the first lift, which was the first and the original Christie lift. That year, I think we pulled in a total of $3,000. Five of us ran the lift, took turns. We didn't have a top attendant in those days. We just told our customers, the few that we had, that if you don't get off, you'll come back down again. And sometimes that actually happened.
In 1964, Buddy Werner took leave to ski in a movie being filmed in the Swiss Alps. There was an avalanche, and Steamboat learned he would never return. It was then that the big mountain, Storm Mountain, was renamed Mount Werner in tribute to his memory. The ski area would grow slowly for the next 7 years. Financing was still touch and go, but lifts were built, trails were cut, an A-frame was built, Ralph Selch's restaurant was installed in the top floor, and Skeeter Werner would run a sports shop and ski school downstairs. There was a new parking lot, of sorts.
I can remember putting on the five-buckle overshoes and carrying people from their cars over, from the porch over to their cars in the afternoons. They'd drive in on frozen ground in the parking lot around the A-frame, and by 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon, it'd thaw out and be anywhere from 6 to 12 inches of mud out there. So things gradually grew up, and the parking lot gradually got enough gravel in it that the mud wasn't knee-deep every time we had a warm day.
By 1968, the operation was well on its way to success. But as always, the mountain was demanding massive new financing. The area was put on the market, and 1969 was purchased by Dallas conglomerate Ling Temco Vogt. That fall, a contract was let in Switzerland for the area's first six-passenger gondola. From then on, it would be modern times.
When I first became involved with it, there was one double chairlift, Christie one, and one pommel lift, and it involved probably around 700 acres of skiing. And there at the most. Now we have 20 lifts, and we have right at 2,600 acres of skiing on the mountain. And you know, our employment obviously has gone from about 30, 40 people to somewhere in the wintertime around 900 people.
Today's area, under the ownership of the Northwest Colorado Ski Corporation, has spread beyond the bounds of Mount Werner to take in the four peaks of a small mountain range: Sunshine Peak, Storm Peak, Thunderhead Peak, and Christie Peak. Steamboat has become a destination resort for the world. Mountains will always remain. Winter will come. The snow will shine up there on the high runs. And the old-time spirit still lives, unchanged and unchanging.
It's hard to beat.
Especially at Steamboat Springs. There's so much to see and do in the Yampa Valley, you can hardly complete it in just one show.
But we're going to try. I'm Brian Harden.
And I'm Karen Collins. Sit back and enjoy the ride and discover Steamboat.
Place called Steamboat Springs. Isn't it beautiful? What are you going to do while you're here? Plenty. You could spend all summer here and still not do everything. Lots of folks have had a good time trying. Access to the many activities on the mountain starts with a scenic ride up the Silver Bullet Gondola. It's open every day from 10 to 4. Once you're at the top, there's lots to enjoy. Mountain biking can be the most fun you've had since you were a kid. There are trails for all abilities on the mountain, from easy cruising roads to some tough single-track trails. You can bring your own bike up in the gondola or explore Steamboat's trails on a rental bike. Mountain bikes, including a new fleet of performance mountain bikes, are available to rent at both the upper and lower gondola terminals. We have some friendly folks to get you started and to point you in the right direction. If you enjoy hiking, the Vista Nature Trail encircling the top of Thunderhead Peak offers interpretive information on wildlife habitat and native vegetation. The views of the Yampa Valley and the Steamboat Ski Area can be enjoyed from one of several picnic areas along the way. Hikers will also find the Thunderhead Trail, a scenic route to the base area, as well as numerous additional trails spanning across Mount Werner. Don't forget to pick up a trail map. It gives you all the information you'll need to enjoy your hike or bike ride.
Here's something great for the younger crowd. There's a place called the Kids Adventure Club. This isn't a boring place where kids are left till the folks are done having fun. It's a place where kids get to make new friends and see what Steamboat is all about. Kids from 3 to 12 get to go out into nature and experience the things Steamboat has to offer. Mountain biking, water sports, games, lots more. Kids Adventure Club operates daily. Activities are provided from 9 to 4, and kids are welcomed as early as 7:30 and cared for through 5:30. Okay, you've had a great time. Maybe used some muscles you didn't know you had. It's time to eat and rest. Not necessarily in that order. And there's plenty of mountaintop dining available at Thunderhead, offering a variety of dining experiences to suit your palate. At the top of the Silver Bullet, you can relax on the sun deck or lunch at the summer barbecue. Sunday brunch at Hazy's is a favorite with locals and visitors alike. This all-you-can-eat buffet includes hot entrees, fresh fruits, Danish pastries, cheeses, and much more. Hazy's is open for dinner on Friday and Saturday nights. The a la carte dinner includes a Silver Bullet gondola ride. The Silver Bullet is also available for evening rides on Friday and Saturday nights. For information about all activities on the mountain, call 879-6111. You know, they say that folks visit Steamboat to ski, but they stay because the summers are so incredible. I believe them.
Some of the more exciting bike trails on Mount Warner include the Storm Peak Challenge, which brings you to the highest elevation, the Valley View Trail, also Creekside, which includes the challenge of water crossings, the Zigzag Loop, which takes you to the top of Thunderhead, and new this year, the Sunshine Trail Loop. In addition to the trails on the mountain, there are a couple of intermediate runs close to town that are truly exciting. Emerald Mountain starts right in Steamboat off the 20-mile road. It's a steady intermediate climb most of the way up the mountain, and once on top, the views are spectacular. Another fun trail is the Hot Springs Run. From town, head out on Strawberry Park Road. Where the pavement ends, the road starts a steady climb that eventually leads to the Hot Springs parking area. The bike trail shoots off into the woods and turns into a single track and comes out at Mad Creek Trailhead on Route 129. From here, it's an easy glide back to town along Elk River Road. What are you looking at, Brian?
I think you can see the Heavenly Days Brewery and Grill from here.
It's 8 in the morning. Don't tell me you're already thinking about beer.
Of course not. I'm thinking about lunch.
If you've worked up an appetite and could use a cool one, then you're at the right place. The Heavenly Days Brewery and Grill. The Days is a restaurant, microbrewery, and nightclub all in one building. You'll never have to leave.
Hi, I'm Artie. I'm the brewmaster here at the Days. As you can see, here at the Days, we've got a nice variety of handcrafted beers. Now let's go up to the brewery. This is our state-of-the-art brewing equipment where we can pump out 1,500 gallons a week for distribution throughout the state and here at our own pub.
On the second floor of Heavenly Days, you'll be treated to a delicious meal in our dining room. The Days specializes in pub cuisine, featuring mouth-watering steaks, delicious pasta, and of course, a children's menu. After dinner, it's time to party at the nightclub on the third floor. The Days features live entertainment every weekend till 2 a.m., where you can dance and listen to the hottest music around. While you're in Steamboat, be sure to stop by the Heavenly Days Brewery and Grill, serving lunch, dinner, and the best hand-built beers in town from 11 till 10. Located in Ski Time Square, or just give a call to 879-8080.
You know, Karen, there's always something fun happening here in Steamboat Springs, whether it's downtown or up here on the mountain.
There's a lot of great shops, along with fine dining and nightclubs, and always exciting activities happening throughout the summer.
This Labor Day weekend, Mount Warner comes alive with the sound of thundering engines. September 2nd through the 4th is the 11th annual Steamboat Vintage Auto Race and Concours d'Elegance. Classic cars from all over the country compete both on the track and on the concourse. While you're checking out the cars of yesteryear, don't miss the Vintage Aircraft Fly-In, which also takes place on Labor Day weekend at the Steamboat Stoleport. These planes are truly a sight to see. September 24th marks the arrival Festival of Autumn in Steamboat Springs with the Fall Foliage Festival in Ski Time Square. This Oktoberfest-style event features a beer garden, wine and beer tasting, polka dancing, and a variety of other fun events the whole family will enjoy. For information on any of these mountain events this summer, contact the Chamber at 879-0882.
While you're on the mountain, stop in at Barton's. You'll be amazed at all they have.
Barton's friendly atmosphere welcomes you with warm hospitality. Step inside and enjoy a cup of cool lemonade as you browse through Barton's tremendous selection of fine artwork, distinctive gifts, and stylish odds and ends for your interior. Owner Lynn Barton Beer and her friendly, helpful staff can assist you in finding exactly what you're looking for.
This saddle is part of the Legends collection. It's done by Willie Witten. He's the sculptor who does a lot of their cowboy and their Indian sculptures.
Barton's also features Gail Pittman's beautiful hand-painted pottery, unique iron sculptures by Gary Russell, and handsome hand-painted cowboy furniture. Don't miss Barton's new selection of home furnishings. The Barton Beer Design Group offers home decorating services, including window treatments, fabrics, wallpaper, rugs, and a variety of upholstered and custom furniture. Call for complimentary design consultation with Ann Perry or Lynn Barton Beer, or stop in Barton's in the Torium Plum Plaza on the mountain. Just up the stairs from the Sheraton or down the stairs from Ski Time Square. There's plenty of free underground parking in the Torian lot. Bring home a piece of Steamboat with you from Barton's, Steamboat's finest art, gift, and interior design shop.
With the addition of the Performing Arts Tent here in the Torian Plum Plaza, Strings in the Mountains has gained enormous popularity. Strings is an ongoing mountain series that features some of the world's best in classical, jazz, and folk musicians. This summer's lineup promises to be one of the best ever. Ticket or schedule information, call 879-5056. The Perry Mansfield Performing Arts School and Camp has brought talented young artists to the Steamboat Springs area for over 80 years. Perry Mansfield productions include works of dance, theater, and performing arts, and are noted as being some of the finest in the country. While you're in Steamboat, see a show or two and help out a worthy cause. Steamboat Springs really add a touch of culture.
And now, Karen, we're going to go downtown to Buggy Whips, where they perform an art all their own.
You guys, there's a few safety things I want to go over with you myself, and then each whatever boat you end up with, we're going to go over a few how to paddle and how to sit in the boat, things like that. First off, the main piece of safety equipment you have is your life jackets. They need to be on all the time, all three buckles buckled, or if you have four buckles, all four buckles need to be buckled, okay? If you do end up in the river and you have to float in the water for a little while, the safest way to go through is to lie on your back, have your feet out in front of you, so any rocks come at you, you're going to get them with your feet first, then you can hold your paddle in something like so, so that if your head farthest upstream, you're going to be in the safest position. So let's go ahead and break up into towards boats and towards groups, and we'll go over how to use paddles, how to sit in the boat, and how to keep these things moving safely so we don't end up in the water, okay?
Basically, we're just doing an intermediate trip today, one of several that we offer. We're on the North Platte River. You know, intermediate trips that we offer are intermediate as far as excitement level goes, but you don't really have to have any previous rafting experience. We just need some people that are wanting a good, exciting, safe ride out there and want to participate and have a real good time. We have some inflatable kayaks that we call duckies that are just really a blast to get in and have a good time for the day. But we do have a full rental program for all any river trips that people want to do on their own. We've got, you know, rafts, dry bags, tents, sleeping bags, inflatable kayaks, paddles, you know, the whole nine yards. So if there are some experienced people out there that want to do a trip on their own, they can come call on us and we can set them up completely for a trip. You know, for all you people out there that are enjoying what you're looking at right now, we've got a lot of fun things to offer, and we'd really like for you to give us a call and get on a trip with Buggy Whips.
Karen, I bet it was a blast, and I definitely don't want to miss where we're going next.
It's one of my favorite places, and it's just down the street, the Old Town Pub.
Hi, my name is Louie. This is the Old Town Pub, and I'd like to invite you into my place. Come on.
Hey, what about me?
Oh, yeah, and by the way, this is my partner, Joe P. Come on inside, we're going to have a good time.
The Old Town Pub is known for two things.
Great food
and a good time.
We have two full bars and some of the country's best microbrew beers on tap. We've been serving both locals and visitors alike for over 10 years and have one of Steamboat's best happy hours.
Mountains of appetizers, slow-cooked prime rib, fresh seafood, and some of the best baby back pork ribs anywhere. We have homemade desserts
and some cute waitresses. Well, hope you've enjoyed your time at the Old Town Pub.
So when you're in Steamboat, for good times and great food,
join us at the Old Town Pub.
Karen, it's no wonder the Old Town Pub is the locals' favorite hangout spot.
And Brian, I have another perfect place that will be great on a day like today. Let's go to the Steamboat Health and Rec.
All right.
It's summertime in Steamboat, and it tends to get a bit warm up here. What better place to cool off than Steamboat Health and Recreation, a modern fitness complex right on Main Street, famous for its natural hot mineral pools, water slide, and lap pool. The water slide is open noon to 6 p.m. daily. Soak your aches and pains away in the hot mineral pools with temperatures ranging from 98 to 102 degrees. Steamboat Health and Rec also offers complete fitness facilities with free weights, stair climbers, and various other cardiovascular equipment. There are over 30 exercise and circuit classes to choose from each week. Certified instructors teach aerobics, stretching and toning, and step classes. Visit Steamboat Health and Recreation, open 6:30 a.m. till 10 p.m. weekdays, 8 a.m. till 10 p.m. on the weekend. Located at 136 Lincoln Avenue, downtown. Or call 879-1828.
These natural hot pools are something else.
But now I'm ready for something just a little bit colder.
If you're in the mood for fun in the sun, bring the family down to Stagecoach Reservoir. Stagecoach is located just 17 miles south of town. Stagecoach Marina is a full-service marina with every kind of rental boat you can imagine. From canoes and fishing boats to fully equipped party barges, Stagecoach has got it all. Wanna really have fun? Hop on a ski boat and hold on tight. It's non-stop excitement. Or grab a jet ski for the afternoon and hop the waves. A party barge is just the ticket for a day of fun a whole group will enjoy. Pack up the family or friends, stock up with food from the marina, and have a picnic on the water. And don't forget the fishing poles. Stagecoach is one of the best lakes in the area for hefty trout. For those of you who just like to relax on shore, Stagecoach has a sandy beach with a swimming area so you can kick back while the kids have a ball. If you really want to wear the kids down, take out a paddle boat and watch them go. Stagecoach has something for everyone, so bring the family for a day of fun. Remember, Stagecoach is a state park, so a $3 parks pass is required for every vehicle. For information, call Stagecoach Marina at 736-8342.
Brian, that was wild.
Wild. Buffalo Wild Wings and WEC. That's BW3 to you and me. Come join the Buffalo at BW3 and have a blast. Link up and play the world live on the interactive QB1 satellite sports and trivia game. Always free and tons of fun. BW3 is always a great time. Bring the family for some tasty onion rings, beef on WEC, buffalo wings, fajitas, and much, much more. BW3 features a complete bar and has more than 18 beers on tap, including Samuel Adams. The Buffalo knows that the service is always fast and friendly at BW3, and if you're in the mood for some excellent entertainment, BW3 books some of the hottest national bands in the country. If you're looking for good food, great family fun, and the best live music, come into BW3, downtown Steamboat, or call 879-2431.
Brian, wake up.
Huh? What?
No visit to the Yampa Valley would be complete without checking out some of the most scenic area just south of here.
That's White River National Forest, home of the Flat Tops.
It's truly some of the most beautiful country in Colorado.
The Flat Tops are a series of high mountain plateaus south of Steamboat Springs, spanning several hundred square miles. Long extinct volcanic vents filled with water and created hundreds of alpine lakes. To get to the Flat Tops, head south of Steamboat on Highway 131, past Stagecoach and Oak Creek to Phippsburg. Turn right on Road 15 and stay right to meet up with Road 132. In 3 miles, you'll connect with County Road 8. 8 is a maintained gravel road that winds through the Flat Tops for about 50 miles. Ripple Creek Pass tops out at 10,400 feet and provides stunning views of the Flat Tops and surrounding valleys. In a few more miles, Trappers Lake Road heads south, leading to one of the most popular spots in the area. Trappers Lake is home of a healthy population of naturally reproducing cutthroat trout and provides excellent fishing. There are several campgrounds in the area, as well as miles of hiking trails. Just half a mile east of Trappers is Coffin Lake, a small, seemingly barren lake hidden in the timbers. But don't be fooled. Fish of incredible size can be lurking in the shallows. Getting them to bite, though, is the hard part. From Coffin Lake, the trail continues for another mile to Little Trappers Lake. It's well worth the hike, both for the scenery and the fishing. 12-inch cutthroats are average here, and the lake can be easily fished from the shore. Another route to the Flat Tops is through Craig. Take Highway 13 south towards Meeker, then follow Road 8 again towards Trappers Lake. From this direction, the road is paved a good part of the way, so it's a little bit easier on your car. Near Beaufort, Road 10 cuts to the right. Follow the South Fork of the White River for about 10 miles. The road ends at South Fork Campground, a beautiful spot to stop for the night. The Flat Tops are a nature lover's paradise, offering countless lakes and streams, numerous campgrounds, and over 400 miles of hiking and horseback trails. Plan on spending a day or two here. It's well worth the trip.
Karen, it looks like Ski House has all their inner tubes out. You up for a dip in the river?
You bet, but first I want to check out all their new summer gear inside.
Dave, wake up. Get out of there. We got customers.
Ski House is your gateway to the great outdoors. Steamboat's most complete mountain store is just off Highway 40 at Pine Grove Road in Steamboat. Ski House is the summer supplier of fine climbing, camping, hiking, mountain biking, and inline skate gear and accessories. Try the in-house climbing wall and check out the Black Diamond climbing equipment. Get inside their North Face tents, the best in the world. Check out the new ProFlex Schwinn and Scott bikes with the hottest suspension systems and the comfortable K2 Exotech and Rollerblade inline skates. Of course, you can rent bikes, skates, and even Ski House scooters.
Hey, wait a second, Dave. Where are you going?
Sorry, Nat. I feel the need for speed.
Shop for North Face, Patagonia, and Royal Robbins clothing and gear that will last for years at your Summer Fun Superstore. Ski House, in the big white building at the corner of Pine Grove Road and Highway 40 in Steamboat Springs.
Dave, get out of there. Blow that candle out and let's go.
Brian, how cold do you think the water's going to be?
Oh, Karen, it's going to be like bath water.
I am starved.
Well, Brian, I told you we should have stopped at McDonald's for lunch. We were so close.
Oh, my gosh. It looks like the Hamburglar had answered our prayers. Look at the rock over here.
A new McDonald's restaurant resides in Steamboat Springs. A McDonald's with a fresh new look, standing impressively in the shadow of Mount Werner at the corner of Anglers Drive and Highway 40. McDonald's prides itself with the fastest service in town. Whether you're taking advantage of McDonald's efficient drive-through service or dining inside, you'll be greeted with warm, friendly smiles when ordering your delicious meal. McDonald's takes pride in their menu and their service to you, especially the kids. McDonald's Playland is the only one of its kind in Routt County, entertaining kids of all ages with video games, tubes, and other fun things. So for fast, inexpensive food with friendly service, visit Steamboat Springs McDonald's across from the Chamber Visitor Center on Highway 40.
Outdoor adventure, this is one spot you won't want to close by.
That's right, Karen. If it has anything to do with the outdoors, Backdoor Sports has it.
If you're an experienced river rat or a beginning rock climber, make Backdoor Sports your summer sports headquarters.
It's long steel rail and a short
Backdoor Sports is your complete outfitter for kayaking, rock climbing, camping, and backpacking. Backdoor Sports also operates the Steamboat Kayak School, teaching beginners to experts. It's
thrill of kayaking.
As you travel through the night, let me hear you, boy.
With floating down the Yampa is your game, our tube rental service is hard to beat. Visit our store and indulge yourself in the many adventures to be had at Backdoor Sports. Backdoor Sports, located on 9th Street on the Yampa River, across from Hollison Hill, or call 879-6249.
I don't know about you, but I am waterlogged.
What do you say we grab a mountain bike from Slow Saddle and check out the bike path?
That sounds like a great idea.
This is Source Saddle Cyclery, Steamboat cycling specialist. At Source Saddle Cyclery, we not only sell, service, and rent bicycles, we also manufacture them under the Moots label. We're the only authorized permittee in the Route National Forest to lead bicycle tours, and these tours are for all ability levels. We will feature specialized mountain bikes for those of you who need bikes. We also have specialized rental bikes at four locations throughout Steamboat, as well as kids' bikes and trailers to tow the tots. Our service department has been helping cyclists since 1975 and can do everything from minor brake adjustments and overhauls to frame alignment and repair. In addition to bikes, we also have a complete selection of parts and accessories, including helmets, lights, computers, shoes, and just about anything else a cyclist would ever need. That's Source Saddle Cyclery right on the bike path at 1136 Champ Avenue downtown. Open 9 to 6 Monday through Saturday and 10 to 5 on Sundays.
Brian, the bike path's this way.
You're right, Karen, but breakfast at the In Season is this way.
Welcome to the In Season Bakery and Cafe, the locals' choice for fine food. We begin our day before sunrise, working amidst the aroma of delicious baked breads and pastries. The In Season features unique breakfasts, including classical eggs Benedict, Florentine and huevos Benedict, and homemade French toast. The In Season also offers lunch on their patio beside beautiful Soda Creek, serving gourmet soups, salads, and sandwiches, and a daily chef special. Start your day with breakfast and let the In-Season pack a picnic lunch to take with you while you enjoy beautiful Steamboat Springs. The In-Season, a quaint European-style cafe and catering company, located at 131 11th Street, open 7:30 a.m. daily.
So Karen, let's take a quick stop at Fair Exchange. They've got so much cool stuff in here.
All right, Brian, sounds good to me. Welcome to the Fair Exchange, the store that has everything. The Fair Exchange has one of the largest furniture collections in Steamboat Springs, including finished pine furniture and oak business pieces. If you're in a creative mood, you can choose from several unfinished pine furnishings. The Fair Exchange is especially well known in Steamboat for vintage and antique treasures, Western memorabilia, and Army Navy surplus. It's summertime, so take advantage of the Fair Exchange selection of new and consignment clothing, featuring Valentino denim shirts, a huge cowboy boot collection, leather jackets, and much, much more. Unfortunately, we don't have enough time to show you everything the Fair Exchange can offer you, so please stop by the Fair Exchange at the corner of 9th and Lincoln Avenue, downtown Steamboat Springs. Brian, how do you think you're going to carry that on the bike path?
Maybe I should have him ship it to me.
I think that's a good idea.
My name's Julie Orton, and probably for as long as I've lived here, there's been a group of people very interested in developing trails in the community. The community really felt there was a great need for a bike path. As you can look around the community, that we really don't have too many sidewalks here. So it's a little bit unsafe for children, and there wasn't really any place for the kids to ride bikes. Also, there's more and more parks out at the mountain, and it was difficult for people to be able to get back and forth from the town to the mountain. So it was a huge need for this. It's been a difficult process and didn't receive much interest or support from the local governmental entities until our local infrastructure was completed. About 5 years ago, a group got very interested in it again and began really working on it. And the city council at that time was very supportive of the idea of developing trails and developing more recreational kinds of amenities here in Steamboat. Lots of work was done to convince the local populace of what a good idea this was, and they voted for it. And as far as we're aware of it, Steamboat's one of the few places in the whole country that actually has approved find types of funding to build trails. So we're, as always, a unique, wonderful place in that regard. The bike path begins at Dream Island down on the west end of town. Basically, the purpose is to connect all of our parks. So it proceeds along the Yampa River and crisscrosses across what maybe three or four bridges, goes under some underpasses, and goes all the way out past Mount Werner, all the way to the bridge right before the Holiday Inn. It seems like everybody uses the trail. I get compliments on it all the time, and so the people that were involved in doing this are very proud of it. So we see little kids riding their bikes, there's skateboarders, there's people using those little bikes with the low-rider bikes. There's, you know, older people, our senior citizens love to walk here. It's used so much. Fishermen walk along, kayakers, you know, people come along, come stand on the bridges just to watch all the rafters and the kayakers go by. So it's a wonderful community amenity.
An easy way through town, but it also accesses some of the best fishing in the area.
To tell you more about some of the fine fishing in the Yampa Valley, let's go to the professionals at Buggy Whips.
Well, we're up here today doing a little high mountain lake fishing. We're in an area about 40 or 50 miles south of Steamboat, and it's a really sweet place to fish because this gentleman who had this fishery created basically took some great thought into it and has done some really miraculous things with the fishing here on this ranch. What I was saying though is we are blessed in Rock County by having so much public land, you know, for people to get out and enjoy for whatever kind of summer or winter activities they like. Things can get a little bit hectic when you're in the business world. This will take away those business blues and put a Colorado smile on your face, that's for sure.
This is what fishing in Colorado is all about right here, baby. This is it, in a nutshell.
For all your fishing and outdoor needs, Buggy Whips Fish and Float Service has it all. For sale or rent, Buggy Whips can outfit you with tackle, rods, outerwear, and of course, guided fishing trips. So get on a trip with Buggy Whips, located at the 5th Street Marketplace, or call 879-8033.
While Buggy Whips guides will take you just about anywhere, if you want to try fishing on your own, there's a few hot spots close to town you should try. Steamboat Lake State Park sits at the base of Hans Peak, just about 20 miles north of town. Not only is it scenic, but the fishing is super. It's a great place to take the family for a picnic or a camping trip, with plenty of tables, camp spaces, and a swimming beach to boot. Nearby is Pearl Lake. Pearl Lake is smaller and a little bit more secluded and is limited to fly and lure fishing only. This makes it a popular spot for fly riders and belly boaters. And again, the fishing is excellent. To get to Steamboat and Pearl Lake State Parks, head north out of Steamboat on Route 129. About 5 miles up the road, you'll come to Mad Creek Trailhead parking area. This trail follows Mad Creek up into the Mount Circle Wilderness area, which lies to the east of Route 129. Just a couple miles further up the road, the Red Dirt Trail also leads into the Zirkle Wilderness. Both trails are popular with day and overnight hikers and backpackers. Continuing north on Route 129 brings you to the Clark Store, a great place to gas up and stock your coolers. just a few more miles, you'll reach the parks. Remember, they are state parks, and a parks pass is required for every vehicle.
Hey, Karen, I smell barbecue. Is that Fritzy over there in the trees?
Yeah, that's his catering smoker. He's loading it with that hickory he gets from Oklahoma.
Ste-Rock 1!
Don't try that at home. Look at that ice-cold, frosty mug of beer.
It's the smokehouse where you can sit in their cozy bar.
And enjoy the five beers they have on tap, including Newcastle Brown Ale and Pete's Wicked Ale.
And there's three sizes to choose from. Big, bigger, and huge.
The smokehouse has all the nuts you can handle, and you can even throw the peanut shells on the floor.
Look at their juicy hickory smoke delights.
Served by our fast and friendly wait staff. Look at those plates full of smoked ribs, sliced brisket, and all the fixings.
Yum, yum.
And the smokehouse has jamming night every Sunday night. Get up and show your stuff or kick back and enjoy our roadkill specials.
The smokehouse is also in the catering business. They can go into the mountains or anywhere else and keep your food hot and fresh until it's served. The Smokehouse, located in the Thiessen Mall downtown, or call 879-5570. The Smokehouse, where you'll be in hog heaven.
That barbecue sure smells good, Brian.
You know, Karen, Steamboat has something else that gives Texas a run for its money.
What's that, Brian? Oil?
Oh, silly. The rodeo.
Among the exciting events happening downtown this summer is the Steamboat Springs Pro Rodeo Series. Top-ranked cowboys compete every Friday and Saturday night at 7:30 in the Romick Arena.
The Mountain Bike Challenge Series happens every other Wednesday with 10 races throughout the summer. All ages and abilities are welcome. Call Trip at 879-1675 for more information.
Don't miss this year's free concert series on the courthouse lawn. July 8th, NRBQ takes the stage. On July 27th, Zachary Richard brings his Jam and Cajun band to the lawn. And Leon Russell hits the courthouse lawn on August 26th.
Rainbow Weekend is July 16th and 17th. Watch over 60 balloons compete in the annual Balloon Rodeo. Then visit Art in the Park, featuring artists and crafts from all over the country.
Finally, the Triple Crown World Softball Championships happen through the months of July and August, with the finals being played August 19th through the 21st.
For information on any of the events happening in Steamboat Springs this summer, contact the Chamber at 879-0882.
You know, Karen, I'm not sure that we succeeded in showing them everything there is to see here in Steamboat Springs.
How could we, Brian? There's so much to see and do in the Yampa Valley, we could hardly complete it in a whole summer.
But you know, it was sure fun trying.
The important part is, whether you're relaxing in the sun, wandering the streets of Steamboat shopping, or enjoying an exciting activity, get out and enjoy all that Steamboat has to offer.
Thanks for joining us on Discover Steamboat. I'm Brian Harvey.
And I'm Karen Collins.
And we'll see you next time.
There's a place out west, way out west, nestled on the western slope of the Continental Divide in northwest Colorado. The history of this area is a living story of western heritage. Unlike many of the newer resort areas, Steamboat Springs was first a tiny western town long before the recreational sport of skiing made its way into the valley. It was 1913 when the Norwegian ski jumper Carl Howelson brought the sport of ski jumping to Steamboat Springs, and from that day on, things would never be the same. Today, the Steamboat ski area dominates the local skyline. Storm Peak, Sunshine, Thunderhead, and Christie Peak offer the world's finest champagne powder skiing, along with slopes for skiers of every ability, from beginner to expert. Combined with the Silver Bullet 8-passenger gondola are some 20 other chairlifts taking skiers to over 50 miles of trails and 2,500 acres of skiable terrain. Steamboat Springs is an extremely desirable place to come and play. And play is what it's all about. Whether you're a child or just rediscovering the child within, winter in Steamboat has something for everyone. Maybe that's the reason Steamboat Springs has produced more Olympic skiers than any other town in America and is now known as Ski Town USA. Surrounded by the Route National Forest, Steamboat is your winter gateway for unparalleled access to millions of unspoiled acres of backcountry and wilderness. By far, the most popular way to enjoy a day in the backcountry is cross-country skiing. For the experienced skier, a quick trip up to Rabbit Ears Pass is a great way to spend the day. For those without experience in the backcountry, the Steamboat Ski Touring Center is located near the main base area. Here, you can rent the skis, boots, and poles you'll need and receive expert instruction in the techniques of cross-country skiing. Another popular way to explore the backcountry is snowmobiling. A number of tour operators offer guided tours along the Continental Divide. Steamboat Springs is never complete without an evening sleigh ride with dinner and live entertainment. Once you experience the rhythmic sound of hoofbeats crunching through newly fallen snow and breathe the crisp, fresh forest air at night, you'll understand this is the way winter was meant to be enjoyed. With the it's not surprising that Steamboat sees over 1 million winter visitors each year. Yep, the little town of Steamboat Springs sure has changed since Carl Howelson arrived in 1913. And you know, getting to Steamboat Springs has never been easier. Daily direct flights from major U.S. cities bring over 80,000 skiers straight to the Steamboat ski area slopes, bypassing the infamous Denver airport. Why, many people can now have breakfast in Manhattan and lunch at the top of Mount Werner. When we return to more than just a ski town, the world's top Galende jumpers come to Steamboat Springs.
Announcing the opening of Cafe Elena, Steamboat's newest restaurant, located downstairs in the Claremont Inn at 917 Lincoln, serving breakfast from 7 a.m. till 11:30, lunch from 11:30 till 2, and dinner from 5 till 10. Cafe Elena, the place you'll recommend.
One thing that hasn't changed over the years is a consistent weather pattern, which brings over 300 inches of light, fluffy snow each winter. Because of this, Steamboat residents had to develop proficiency with both webbed and Norwegian snowshoes. Webbed, wood, and rawhide snowshoes were good on flat terrain. Better in the mountains were the so-called Norwegian snowshoes, crude wooden skis almost 12 feet long. Recreational skiing grew from these beginnings. What it has evolved into, is anyone's guess. There's snowboarding, freestyle jumping, mogul skiing, cross country, telemark skiing, Nordic jumping, World Cup slalom, giant slalom, and head-to-head racing. And then there's Gelände jumping. Gelände jumping uses ordinary downhill ski equipment, the same skis, boots, and poles that most people use. It's been around as long as skiing itself, but didn't attain popularity until the 1970s. Last year, the Pro Gelände Tour came to Steamboat, delighting onlookers with jumps longer than a football field. Shopping in Steamboat is sure to delight you. Our many shops, boutiques, and galleries offer a surprising variety of practical and gift items. Artwork and Western memorabilia predominate. Look around. You'll find antiques, clothing, and accessories for every taste and every budget. There are five clusters of retail establishments. Many fine shops and restaurants are open all year round at the base of the mountain, Gondola Square, and Ski Time Square. Close by, Central Park Plaza and Sundance Plaza are also home to shops and services. Downtown Steamboat contains the greatest concentration of merchants, including Western Outfitters, galleries, novelty shops, and jewelers. Getting downtown from the ski area is no problem. Like all of Steamboat's attractions, the tennis center, the mountain, and all of downtown are served by the SST, the Steamboat Springs Transit, offering extensive local service and convenient stops clearly marked. Buses run every 20 minutes and every 10 minutes during peak hours. And special van service is available for physically challenged passengers. Located in downtown Steamboat Springs is the Steamboat Health and Recreation Center. To say that a soak in these geothermally heated mineral springs is soothing after a day on the mountain is putting it mildly. Actually, it's relaxing beyond belief. Weight rooms, aerobics classes, facilities for stretching and working out complement the three natural hot springs, the heated Olympic-sized swimming pool, and the popular water slide. The springs are an important part of Steamboat's past. It represents a tradition of healing and renewal that goes way back to the days of the Ute Indians and the early settlers. The Steamboat Health and Rec is an excellent outing for the entire family. Nearby Howlison Hill is the longest continuously operating ski area in the United States and contains one of only three 90-meter ski jumps in the country. They say white men can't jump, but Carl Howlison, the Flying Norseman, was pioneering ski jumping back here in 1913. This is where skiing and steamboat got its start. This facility has now grown into a year-round recreational mecca. While in the summertime, the locals enjoy the softball fields, volleyball beach, tennis courts, skateboard park, motorcycle course, and rodeo arena, winter brings to life the public ice skating rink, downhill race course, the 70 and 90 meter ski jumps, the freestyle jumps, the bobsled run, and of course, one of North America's only ice driving schools where participants learn the finer techniques of driving in ice and snow. When we return to more than just a ski town, ski racing takes to the steamboat ski slopes.
Come to Mango Clothing Company in downtown Steamboat and check out all the happening cotton canton fleece styles. They have twill on the outside, soft warm fleece on the inside, and garment washed in a variety of great colors. We have men's and women's sizes in tops, pants, shorts, and jackets. Also see our wide selection of genuine Gramici sportswear, freedom of movement clothing. Take home a memory of Steamboat from Mango, 617 Lincoln, one half block from the 7th Street downtown shuttle bus stop.
Many kinds of racing characterize winter in Steamboat, but probably the most exciting racing of all is when the pros come to town. In December of 1992, it was the ladies' turn for the serious money at the Ski Town USA Classic. This year's race was so difficult and led to such unexpected results that it made for a particularly exciting competition. February 1994 saw professional ski racing again return to Steamboat Springs. The Women's Pro Ski Tour features head-to-head racing on dual courses with several large jumps between the start and finish. This makes for an interesting day of ski racing, to say the least.
Here, racers, ready?
Trying to make up that time. It's Camilla Lunda on the red. Lunda on the blue. Camilla Lunda on the red. Lunda on the blue.
Amateur competitions are frequent during the winter months in all disciplines of skiing. These are young skiers coming up through the ranks, each dreaming of someday making it to the Olympics. And now that freestyle has achieved Olympic status, there are many young mogul skiers seeking a berth on the Olympic team. This contest, held on Voodoo, was just one of many stops on the amateur tour. Another part of the amateur ski scene is the upright aerials held at Hollison Hill. When we return to more than just a ski town, a look at 70 and 90 meter ski jumping. Here in Steamboat, going back as far as 1913. It's about distance, but it's also about joy, the joy of flight. Jumping is a perfect moment, of airborne meditation requiring skill, daring, and inner discipline. The first winter carnival here in Steamboat took place back in 1914 and was organized by ski jumping pioneer Carl Howelson. It was a way of livening up life in winter during the old days. And ranchers and townsfolks could get together and enjoy a day in the snow. The high-spirited fun and displays of skill serve the same function today. There's snowshoe softball, biathlon, and chariot race competition. There's music and revelry, and it's all topped off with a night show that features Steamboat's own legendary lighted man. The ever-popular street events take place during the mornings with ski joring. That's horses pulling speedy skiers right down Main Street. There are races for kids, kids and dads, and kids, dads, and pets. And then there's the Steamboat Springs High School Marching Band, and of course on skis. Winter Carnival in February is just one of many crazy events which take place during our long winters. January brings the world's top professional rodeo cowboys to Steamboat to ski and race for a day. Now in its 21st consecutive year, this popular event brings 1,000 spectators to the Headwall Racecourse to watch 100 cowboys race head-to-head, then lasso a ski hostess and saddle a horse before crossing the finish line and hopefully all in one piece. But the day's not over until the final race where all the cowboys race down at once. Fun takes place in March with the annual St. Patrick's Day KBCR Jello Jump. Here, contestants must jump into a hot tub filled with cold green jello and hopefully locate a numbered poker chip to win a prize. When we return to More Than Just a Ski Town, we'll see how Steamboat got its name.
Giovanni's Ristorante, a tradition of excellence for over 10 years, offers fine Italian dining and attentive service for the entire family. There's two ways to experience the wonderful ambiance and gastronomic treats of Giovanni's. You can whet your appetite at the bar with bruschetta, fresh mussels fra diavolo, or scampi del giorno, while you sip on one of their many wines by the glass, ice-cold martinis, frozen fruit drinks, or Moretti beer. Or proceed into the relaxed, romantic atmosphere of the dining room. Tantalize your taste buds with a succulent veal chop, veal saltimbocca, filetto al Tuscany, frutti di mare, or sautéed tuna steak. Accompany your feast with a selection from their extensive Italian wine list. Finally, sate your desire for sweets with one of their luscious desserts, and cap off your evening with a cognac, grappa, cordial, or liqueur with a cup of rich espresso or frothy cappuccino. Dining is from 6 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday. For memories that will linger long, call 879-4141. Giovanni's is in Old Town Steamboat on 11th.
The Skier's Pocket Guide to Steamboat Springs, your convenient source for all the information visitors want to know about the Steamboat Ski Area. Inside this easy-to-carry guide, you'll find useful information about Steamboat, mountain facts and rates, tips on skiing and your health, and of course, lots of maps to help you get around. Pocket Guide offers suggestions on where to dine and where to shop, along with ideas for other activities you can enjoy while staying in Steamboat. Pick up your free Pocket Guide at any Steamboat lift ticket counter, all Steamboat brochure locations, and participating merchants and lodges throughout the valley.
The early residents of this valley were Arapahoes and the Yampatika tribe of the Ute Indians, who summered here and migrated west during the winters. According to legend, around 1865, French trappers moving through the area heard the steamboat-like chugging sound of a natural spring, which they called Steamboat Springs. The Utes considered the area springs to be sacred, possessing healing powers. Well, today you can visit the Steamboat Spring behind the library on Stockbridge Road, just across from the Depot Art Center. In 1875, James Crawford and his family were the first settlers to stake a homestead claim here. They got on peacefully with the Utes, trading bread and sugar for arrows, moccasins, and crafts. Steamboat Springs was incorporated in 1900. The task of preserving Steamboat's colorful past falls to the impressive Tread of Pioneers Museum, located in a carefully preserved turn-of-the-century home at 8th and Oak Streets. Open year-round, the museum has chosen the motto, "To preserve the past, to educate for the future." You can visit the polished collection, elaborately displayed in a manner as if the home were occupied today. The quality of the artifacts, the friendly staff, and comfortable atmosphere, combined with a collection including guns, skiing history, and the new Ute exhibit, provide an interesting excursion for the whole family. The museum is now open all year round. Admission for an entire family is just $5, so come to the Tread of the Pioneers Museum and see how it used to be in the good old days.
We started Steamboat Powder Cats in 1983. Jupiter was the guide and I was the driver.
10 years ago, that seems like a long time. Now we have three snow cats, a brand new fancy one with a Mercedes-Benz turbo diesel engine. It's a state-of-the-art snow cat. We have the best skiing terrain imaginable.
We start our day at 7:30 in the morning. The van will pick you up at your condo. We go to Mazzola's restaurant for breakfast, where we also do a little safety meeting. Then we jump in the van, take about a 15-minute ride up to Buffalo Pass, jump in the snowcat, and go skiing all morning.
We start off on mellow, open terrain and work our way up to steeper and steeper and deeper stuff.
We're a PSIA certified ski school. and we've been teaching people to ski powder for 10 years. We provide the wide powder skis this year, and they are a trick. They really help you learn to ski powder. We take intermediate skiers and bring them back feeling like experts.
People come from all over the world to ski with us. People fly up from Aspen just to spend a day with us. Warren Miller comes with us every year and tells us we have the best powder skiing operation in North America.
The greatest experience is at the end of the day when our skiers turn to us and say, "That's the best day of skiing I've ever had in my life."
Come to Mango Clothing Company in downtown Steamboat and check out all the happening cotton canton fleece styles. They are twill on the outside, soft warm fleece on the inside, and garment washed in a variety of great colors. We have men's and women's sizes in tops, pants, shorts, and jackets. Also see our wide selection of genuine Gumichi sportswear, freedom of movement clothing. Take home a memory of Steamboat from Mango, 617 Lincoln, one half block from the 7th Street downtown shuttle bus stop. Announcing the opening of Cafe Elena, Steamboat's newest restaurant, located downstairs in the Claremont Inn at 917 Lincoln. Serving breakfast from 7 a.m. till 11:30, lunch from 11:30 till 2, and dinner from 5 till 10. Cafe Elena, the place you'll recommend.
The pros kick off the season in December. There's a flurry of activity all winter long. Finally, the season winds down in April with the infamous cardboard classic race, a testament to the ingenuity and creativity of the people who spend many months living in thin air at high altitude. This zany race actually began back in 1972 and has grown into the official closing event of the ski season. But with the change of seasons, the melting snow gives way to the fresh green of summer. For a look at what we here in Steamboat Springs will be doing the rest of the year, just take a look.
A legendary Valley of Springs. That's what the first settlers to this area found. A pristine wilderness the Indians held sacred and tried to keep secret. Where the sunlit valley abounds with wildlife and fresh water flows from snow-covered peaks and steaming springs in the earth. Where mountainsides are blanketed with wildflowers and the people reflect the spirit and character of their beautiful natural surroundings. Ever since the days of the pioneers, people have risen to greet each new summer day in Steamboat and have seen options for entertainment as wide as the valley. Today, in fact, there are more activities in Steamboat than time to try them. Take part in summertime events like the Pro Rodeo Series every Friday and Saturday night, featuring professional rodeo cowboys roping and riding their way to fame and glory. Or attend the Strings in the Mountains Chamber Music Series, presenting internationally acclaimed musicians. For a different perspective, ride to the top of Thunderhead Peak on the Silver Bullet Gondola. Or visit Fish Creek Falls, 283 feet of thunder and spray. Challenge the fairways and greens of the Robert Trent Jones Jr. Championship Golf Course. Participate in a marathon, a 10K race. Photograph dozens of hot air balloons rising in the cool morning air. And visit Art in the Park during Rainbow Weekend. Watch legendary automobiles compete on the streets of Steamboat during the Vintage Auto Race, Labor Day weekend. Whatever you decide to do, remember, special events in Steamboat are indeed special because they showcase the true spirit and character of this 116-year-old town. Neighborly, down-home feelings are a part of everything you do. Just one small detail, though. Before the Indians left the Valley of Springs, they placed a curse on all who visit here to come back again and again. See you soon.
For more information on any of the activities you have seen or heard about on More Than Just a Ski Town, call or write the Steamboat Springs Chamber Resort Association, P.O. Box 774408, Steamboat Springs, Colorado 80477-4408, or telephone area code 303-879-0882. Thanks for joining us. We hope you enjoy your stay.
Giovanni's Ristorante.
Thank you. Champagne Hour is brought to you by American Express.
Hi, I'm Billy Kidd, Director of Skiing here at Steamboat, and we've put together a quick guide to help you get acquainted with our mountain. The Gondola Square base area is at the bottom of the mountain. Just look for the clock tower. This is where you purchase your lift tickets, get information, check lost and found, ride the Silver Bullet gondola, or sign up for the ski school. It's here you'll find the Steamboat Ski Rentals, offering extraordinary ski rentals at ordinary prices. Just steps from the gondola, Steamboat Ski Rentals has been designed to anticipate your needs. You'll find under one roof all the services you need to start your vacation or your day. Steamboat Ski Rentals offers brand new ski equipment, including the latest in high-performance skis from K2, Rossignol, Salomon, Kessley, or Volant. You'll find a great selection of hats and goggles at the accessory shop, and you can buy your lift ticket here or even book a ski lesson. Overnight ski storage and professional ski tuning are available, and kids rent free. Some restrictions apply, so call 879-6111, extension 345 for reservations. If you are picking up pre-purchased ski lesson packages, be sure to take advantage of the Ski School Express line, located at the Ski School ticket office. Steamboat Ski School is recognized as one of the finest in the world and offers a full line of programs to suit all ages and ability levels, including specialty programs like the Style Clinic, Bumps Clinic, the Powder Experience, Black Diamond Club, snowboard and Telmark lessons, women's ski seminars, and NASTAR race clinics. The Billy Kidd Center for Performance Skiing provides personalized programs for intermediate and advanced skiers, including racing camps. And what I've found over the years is that people want to learn how to ski better, and this is one of the best ways to do it. Watch some of the really good racers. These are some of the best in the United States racing here in Steamboat today. Watch how they keep their feet apart for good balance. They keep their hands out like a tightrope walker when the going gets tough. They make round, smooth turns so their skis carve rather than skid. At the Billy Kidd Center for Performance Skiing, we try to apply what those racers are doing to help you ski better in the bumps or bad visibility or whatever. So let's go out on the mountain and I'll show you how we do it.
Chin up, look ahead, let's see a pole plant in each and every turn now. Racer ready, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Attaboy! Look ahead now!
Yes, we really like to coach kids like TJ in the race course. We'll teach you in the bumps. We'll teach you in all types of terrain. You'll learn to ski better if you learn from skiers who are the best in the world. Skiers like Olympic medalist Nelson Carmichael. For information or reservations about all programs offered at the Billy Kidd Center for Performance Skiing, call 879-6111, extension 543. And remember, you can join me for my 1 o'clock run. It's a free clinic down an intermediate trail, and I'll tell you everything I know about how to improve your skiing. You can check at the information center or at the top of the gondola to see if I'm skiing that day. For the younger skiers, Rough Riders classes are available for kids from first grade through 15 years. For information on all our ski school programs, call 879-6111, extension 531. Steamboat's fun-filled Kids Vacation Center offers ski programs for children 3.5 to 6 years at any level of skiing ability. Activities include lunch, lift tickets, and the finest care available. Our instructors teach the young bunch to carve up the slopes while they're playing games, and we make sure they're getting their full quota of fun, too. And there is also a Kitty Corral Daycare Center that allows parents to enjoy a carefree day on the slopes, knowing that their children are under supervision and supplied with activities and entertainment. For information on all Kids Vacation Center programs, call 879-6111, extension 469. The Silver Bullet Gondola opens every morning at 8:30, and the Burgess Creek Lift opens at 8:45, so you can get in those early morning runs. All the other lifts on the mountain open at 9 o'clock. The BK Corral, located on the third floor of the upper gondola terminal, opens with a Silver Bullet gondola and offers skiers a hearty all-you-can-eat breakfast buffet before hitting the slopes. For lunch, you can dine at any one of six different restaurants on the mountain. The Stoker Bar at the Thunderhead offers sit-down service where you can relax and enjoy a hot drink, cocktail, or full lunch. On the second floor is Hazy's, which offers sit-down dining with a contemporary menu, an extensive wine list, and an incredible view. Reservations are recommended, so call 879-6111, extension 465. For a wide variety of fast food, try the Thunderhead BK Corral. It's our largest cafeteria and offers the fastest, most complete service. There's also a barbecue on the sun deck outside. Located in the Priest Creek area is the Rendezvous Saddle Facility. It houses another cafeteria along with a sun deck barbecue and Ragnar's, a gourmet restaurant featuring dining in the Scandinavian tradition. Reservations are suggested, so call 879-6111, extension 465. Located near the top of the Four Points lift is the Four Points Hut, offering light snacks and beverages. For a truly unique dining experience, take a starlight ride on the Silver Bullet gondola to dinner at the Thunderhead. Dine on your choice of all-you-can-eat barbecue at the BK Corral, along with live country and western music, or enjoy a wide variety of gourmet cuisine prepared by our master chef at Hazy's while listening to classical dinner music played on the Baby Grand. Or experience a dining adventure by taking a sunset sleigh ride across the mountain to Ragnar's. You'll enjoy a gourmet dinner in spectacular surroundings reminiscent of Steamboat's earlier days, and at the same time enjoy acoustic music in harmony with the surroundings. Call 879-6111, extension 465, for reservations. For the best ski hat selection in Steamboat, you should check out the mountain accessory shops at Thunderhead and Rendezvous Saddle. Goggles, sunscreen, and many other ski accessories are also available. Steamboat's lift system is one of the biggest in North America, designed to keep people skiing, not waiting, especially if you take advantage of the Storm Peak Express and the Sundown Express, our two high-speed covered quads. Lift status signs are located at the gondola base and at various places on the mountain, so you can check for yourself if there are any lines and decide where you would like to ski. Remember that ski conditions change with weather conditions, and be sure to ski on a trail that matches your ability. The Basher Race Area is where most of our ski racing takes place, and there are options for all abilities. NASTAR allows you to compare your time with racers of your own age and sex and win a medal if you ski fast enough. The dual coin-operated race course runs next to NASTAR and allows you to race a friend head-to-head down a dual course and compare times. Discount multi-run cards are available, or single runs are a dollar. Basher is also the location for group picnics and barbecues. Steamboat has different special events and activities going on all winter long. Sleigh rides, ballooning, dog sledding, or any number of scheduled events like the Winter Carnival or the Cowboy Downhill. To find out more about any activity on the mountain or off, contact the Information Center at the Gondola Base area. Need a lift to town? Going out to dinner? Take a bus. The SST is Steamboat's public transportation system, and it's 50 cents for a ride to town or back up to the mountain. Maps are available at many locations, including the Transportation Center, right behind the Gondola Base area. Shuttle passenger vans are available around the base area for the convenience of our guests. These vans shuttle from the Meadows and Knowles parking lots and will run continuously from 6 a.m. until 1 a.m. throughout the ski season. If you'd like to know the latest snow conditions, call the ski report at 879-7300. So if you have any questions, please feel free to ask any of our employees for assistance. We are here to see that you have a great ski vacation. John Hewitt will be along in a moment to tell you about many other activities and events that we enjoy throughout the ski season here in Ski Town, USA. See you on the slopes.
Hi, I'm Rick DeVos, and I'm with the Steamboat Ski School. Today's ski tip is on absorbing the terrain while skiing in the moguls. The toughest part about skiing bumps is dealing with this constantly changing terrain. I'm going to show you a few things that will help you deal with this by allowing yourself to flex in the knees and ankles and absorb the terrain like you have shock absorbers. Come on, let's give it a try. For this exercise, try it while traversing. Traverse across a hill, let your knees and ankles flex freely to absorb the terrain. Try that in both directions until you get good at it. Remember to use your legs as shock absorbers as you ski in the bumps. Your knees and your ankles should be allowed to flex very smoothly. It'll help take the real bump out of the bumps.
Steamboat has a wide variety of special events happening all season long. Events like Cowboy Downhill. Put together 100 cowboys, a few gates and a jump, some shiny new skis, and you get the craziest downhill race in America. It happens every January right here in Steamboat. Hang on to your hats. It's one of the biggest comedy shows on skis you will ever see.
All right.
We get over that jump, we got her made.
Good luck.
And we're going to need it, I promise you.
I never won anything. I usually have a little trouble with that jump.
What do you mean, training? You mean like drinking training?
Oh, we're all loosened up. We started this morning.
Yeah.
First thing, 9 o'clock, we had a gobbler. Ow!
Best time you can have right here at Steamboat. This is the event for the cowboys. Steamboat Springs really goes out of the way. The Steamboat Ski Corp have us up here. We've been coming, like I say, for 20 years. Look out, Steamboat. A crash is in the process.
The second weekend in February is reserved for the Winter Carnival, Steamboat's celebration of winter. The first Winter Carnival was way back in 1913, and this, the 81st annual Winter Carnival, continues to be the oldest festival of its type in the United States. This is the locals' chance to get out with their families and compete in events and activities that only a fun-loving Western ski town could dream up. There are ski-joring races, parades with the world's only marching band on skis, shovel races, but you have to be at least 18 to get into that one. And the highlight of the week, coming during the night show with all the fireworks and torchlight parades, is Steamboat's own Lighted Man. Steamboat continues to have its share of the best in international competition, including World Cups. Events like the Subaru Ski Town USA Classic, featuring the finest women's slalom and giant slalom skiers in the world, and this year, a Nordic Combined World Cup. There are always any number of fun things to watch and participate in here in Steamboat. For more information on any activity, call the ski area at 879-6111 or go by the information center at the base of the Silver Bullet. Colorado ski wear has always marked the height of winter fashion. Now, ski area employees here in Steamboat Springs are sporting brand new, environmentally sensitive outfits. The fabrics are durable and warm, and they breathe. But for 1,000 employees of Steamboat Springs ski area in the northern Colorado Rockies, you might say they found their clothes in the garbage. What gives?
This is post-consumer polyester. So rather than taking and using raw oil to create the insulations, we're now taking and using plastic bottles.
That's right. Each of these jackets contains the equivalent of 5 used soda pop bottles. The fiber is called EcoSpun, a polyester material formed from the plastic in pop bottles. The discarded bottles are pulverized, remelted, and forced through tiny holes to create a new fiber, usable in home insulation or for clothing. The idea for EcoSpun ski wear is a joint effort of Steamboat Springs Ski Area and Rafi Corporation, a major manufacturer of ski clothing.
Not only are we making jackets as warm as we can possibly make them, but we're also taking an awful lot of plastic bottles out of landfills.
Rafi is based in Seattle, the capital of grunge clothing. But there's nothing grungy about these ski outfits. Steamboat ski employees will sport fashionable Dimitri sweaters and colorful ski jackets. And all of it was once tossed on the trash heap as throwaway plastic soda pop containers.
Right now, consumers will select and seek products that show that the manufacturer is environmentally responsible.
So drink up. That Pepsi or Coke you have for lunch today may go down just as easy on the slopes in Colorado this ski season.
I'm still ranching, and that's what I want to do. I've got a brother that I guess maybe made $1 million, but I wouldn't trade with him if I starved to death running cows here.
It's a physical atmosphere. Everyone is involved with being outdoors.
This will make 61 years I've pulled skiers behind a horse on Main Street ski carnival time.
What's the use of going anywhere when you're already there?
The Morning News Minute. A good ski day, lots of powder. Let's check the conditions.
Good morning from Ski Town, USA. This morning we're reporting a 45-inch base at Mid-Mountain and a 63-inch base at the summit with 12 inches of fresh powder in the last 24 hours. Since 3 p.m. yesterday, we've received 9 inches of new snow at Mid-Mountain and 7 inches at the summit. The temperature on the mountain at 5 a.m. was 10 degrees, the winds are calm, and skies over Steamboat are clearing.
I'm up on the mountain before the first crack of light. Work to get done ahead of the sun, making the mountain light. Some of my brothers and sisters have been up most of the night. But to be sure the skiing's perfect, making the mountain right. Generators humming, put a broom to the snow.
catch your bones. This mountain's getting ready to go. The sun peeks through the window. What a beautiful sight. Things to prepare, they better be there when you're making the mountain right. Up on the mountain early, before the first crack of light. Work to get done ahead of the sun. Making the mountain right. Up on the mountain early.
107 trails, 2,500 skiable acres, 4 towering peaks. Steamboat is one of the biggest ski mountains in North America, with every type of terrain imaginable. And when you're the place to ski, you'd better run that mountain so that people spend their time skiing. That means getting you up those 4 peaks fast and comfortable. At Steamboat, we have one of the most advanced lift systems in skiing. The 8-passenger high-speed silver bullet gondola and our 2 covered high-speed quads get you from bottom to top, covered all the way. Steamboat lifts you. There are so many ways to end your day in Ski Town, USA. Settle down in something warm and natural, springs that is, or spring to life making figure eights on ice. Enjoy the western nights with welcome lights that beckon you inside. Feel the warmth of a cozy room after a snowy sleigh ride. They play music here, you hear, from a ballad sung with sweet guitar to the rhythm of reggae. Yes, there are so many ways to end your day in Ski Town, USA.
Gotta love the downhill, cowboy downhill.
It ain't nothing like riding bucking horses, but it's fun.
Climb downhill and keep upright. Try to keep from getting horizontal, you know. And I'm one of the lucky ones. I live here. Some folks have to leave this place.
Yeah! Getting here is easy. Leaving is tough. Once you get to Steamboat, you just can't get enough. It's the powder, the beautiful snow. Some say it's the people.
spell has a way of getting to you. The folks not here to know too well. Yeah, getting here is easy when you come on a plane. Almost next to no time, you're skiing the terrain.
The big jets bring you right here to the Yampa Valley Regional Airport.